Let's take a look at how to control overflow on Editor X. You might have elements like images, buttons, or text that flow over the borders of the container or section they're placed in. And there are three ways to control how this overflowing content is displayed. We'll take a look at how to show overflow content, hide it, or have it scroll through a container or section. Here's how it works. We can set the overflow properties for sections and containers. This section is set to show overflow content, which is the default. So when an element extends outside of the section, we can still see it. Now, we want these shapes in our design to be cropped off at the top so that it looks like the header is overlapping them a bit. So we'll drag them slightly outside of the section. But since the overflow content is set to show, we can still see the full shapes. So to get that cropped effect we were going for, we'll set the overflow content for this section to hide. And now, you can see all the content that extends beyond this section is no longer shown. In this next section, we want the final design to have a longer piece of text inside this white container, and achieve this effect where we scroll through the text itself without scrolling through the section. So right now, this container has a bit of text in it, and the container is taking up the entire height of the section, which is set to 70 VH. Like we saw, there's a lot more text that we need to add to this container. But now, it's overflowing outside of the container and section. One way to fix this is by setting the height of the section to auto. That means the section will automatically resize to fit the content inside of it, like this. But now, we've got this taller section which doesn't really match the design we're going for. So let's undo that and instead set the overflow content for this section to scroll. This creates a scroll within the section, but it also means that all of the elements in this section will scroll, not just the text. That doesn't help us much either, so we'll set the section overflow back to show. What we'll do now is set the overflow property of the container itself to scroll. This way, visitors can scroll through the text while the other elements in the section stay in place. We can also choose the scroll direction, vertical, horizontal, or both, and we can choose to show or hide the scroll bar. And because we set this overflow property for the container, we'll make sure it's stretched so that it's the full height of the section. Now, let's preview the design. We achieve that overlapping look at the top, and in the next section, we can scroll through the text in the container beautifully. And once we reach the bottom of this content, the page starts scrolling again as normal. Same goes when we scroll back to the top. Editor X is an advanced creation platform. To master it, continue watching this series of video tutorials.